Welcome viewers. Today I have taken a topic, writing an effective research paper. Normally, why we write a research paper? As per UGC guideline, every researcher has to write two research papers in peer-reviewed journal or SCI journal or Scopus journal before submission of his or her PhD. So for the long time, I was thinking to deliver a lecture on writing an effective research paper. With my long experience, I have tried to explain each and every aspect of writing a research paper. Today, my presentation will consist of overview of research writing, structure of research paper subsection and sections, then suggestion for improving the effectiveness of writing. Now the first question which comes to our mind is that, what is research paper? If we define as a layman language, research paper is a written document which is written with the output of research or findings of research which one conducts for his work. So therefore, a substantial piece of academic writing usually done as a requirement for a class in which author does an independent research into a topic and writes a description of findings of that research. Now, what is the purpose of research paper? The first one, we want to share the knowledge which we gained from our research and discussion with other researchers. Whatever we do research, we want to share the knowledge with others. Similarly, we want to show that how my research study fits into the current science or current scenario. Third, very important point, informing the public about the important scientific activity which you have or I have taken for completing a task. We will discuss now that what are the factors which affect the research writing quality. The first one is coherence. Coherence means we want all the information at one place. That means the each section should contain the information only with reference to that particular section. Second important point, we should not try to repeat the information unless necessary. Sometimes we have to repeat the information, but we should try to avoid. So two things are important in coherence. The information should be related to the section and there should not be any repetition of the information. Second is organization. We have to follow TAIMRD rule. Title, abstract, introduction, method, research, discussion, or conclusion rule. That is the very common rule which normally all the publishers prescribe for the authors. Second point in organization is that put the right parts in right place. That means whatever is required in the introduction section should not be given in method or result. Whatever is required in introduction section, it should be put in the introduction section. Third point is relevance. Now we have to see the journal guideline or the guidelines prescribed in a conference, and we should try to focus on these guidelines and we have to conform to the guideline. That means if the guideline is your 3000 words, we should limit our research paper within 3000 word limit. Another thing is that it has been observed that when we write the research paper, we do not see the limitation. Every data is important for you, but you have to select a data which is required or which is essential for your paper, for defining the result or for explaining the result of your paper. That is the two things: conformance to the length and limited data use. Fourth one is clarity. Whenever you write, you think, or I think, that I am the best writer in the world and whatever we are writing is excellent. Therefore, one has to see that whether whatever we have written is easy to read or understand. For that, there is a very, very layman suggestion that suppose you write and complete your writing on Monday, at least give 1 day or 2 day time and pick up that document on Wednesday, and you will find that now you are looking as a evaluator for that particular document. So then you can be best judge for evaluating your own script or your own document. Second point is that we Indians are very poor in grammar, phrasing and style. Therefore, we should not hesitate in taking the help of an expert in case of grammar, phrasing and style. Now, what is happening, even MS Word has given your grammar check or style. We can use that particular aspect of Microsoft to make our sentence more clearer. Now, there is a checklist for writing a paper. Every journal, conference, or even in a class, there is a particular format, rule, or style which is prescribed. We have to see whatever we are written is matching with the target journal style or conference. Second thing is, which is very important, every journal give the guide for the author. There is a section, guidelines to author, guideline for author, or author guideline, whatever be the title, one has to read carefully these instruction which has been prescribed by the journal for the author. Now, this is a TA IMRD format, which says the first one is abstract, second one is abstract, third one is introduction, method, result, discussion, / conclusion. If you just see that method and result, they constitute the central report section. And information moves from broad to specific and then to broad. This is a structure of a research paper. If you just see at the top, it is a title, then followed by abstract and a funnel which is put at the top of a circle, and you will find one is your introduction. An introduction means what is known, that is our understanding of the work. If you see the second, what is unknown gap, or with the help of literature review, what are the gaps which we want to fill up. Third one is the how and why should we fill the gap. That means our rationale for the study, our the purpose for the study, or we can say a hypothesis. Fourth one is the method that whatever is the gap is identified, and the method which we have selected for filling up the gaps. So how you will do, or what will we do to fill up the gaps? Then fifth one is the bottom one. So if you just see the top, we are going from broad to specific, and then from specific to broad. Fifth is the result. What result did we get? Means when we have applied the methods to fill the gap, that what are the result which we are getting is very important. Sixth one is discussion. And in this discussion, we have to write how do the result fill the gap. Then finally, the conclusion. What does it mean for us going forward? That means with the result which we have obtained, the discussion which we have made, how we can go. If we are going forward, then is there any meaning to going forward? Now the first which comes in our, the section, that is the introduction. We will discuss the title and abstract also. The first one is introduction. So what does we do in introduction? We discuss the problem which is to be solved. We describe where our research or your research fit in the current science. Then uses the primary literature and summarize the current undertaking of the problem. That means we write that Agarwal and Shankar 2006 has done the work in the area of supply chain management, and they found that online trust is based on following variables. So we have to give some literature in the introduction also. Second is a method. Method tells how you did the study. It also tells what materials, methods of experimentation and analysis were used. That means, suppose we want to study the student satisfaction level of IGNOU student, then how you will we will do the study? That means we will conduct a survey. Then what materials and the method of experimentation? We will take a strata, we will take a population, then we will decide the strata, we will develop the questionnaire, we will do the pilot study. All that comes under the method. Third is result. Result is very important, and here we have to write the important findings. Remember, we are not giving here the importance of the finding. We are only giving that important finding of our study or your study, and try to help our research question. Here we are not going to give the importance of finding, only we will give the important finding. Finally, we will go for discussion or conclusion. It explains what is the meaning of our finding, what are the implications of our study. Here in conclusion or discussion, we also explain the limitation of work and discuss the future research that is needed. Suppose we have conducted a research for automobile sector, we can write that our study is based on the input received from automobile or automotive company, and this is not valid and it cannot be generalized for fast moving consumer goods company or electrical and electronic goods company. So this is a limitation that should be mentioned in the discussion. Now let me ask you a very questions, that which factor does not affect the quality of research? The first one is coherence. Yes, we need the coherence because it affects the quality. Clarity, we have seen that there should be a clarity in our writing. Organization, we need an organization of all our information in a proper manner. But novelty does not affect the quality. If the paper is in novel, if the research is novel, it does not affect the quality of research, because how much novel is there, it depends on how we are writing our research paper. Second question is that what is expected in the discussion or conclusion? Is it present the findings of our research, or gives the context or background of our research, explain the meaning of findings, include implication? That is the correct answer that comes under the discussion. Discuss how your study is conducted, that is the matter of method, that will come under the method. So in this case, the meaning of finding, implication and limitation will come under the section discussion / conclusion. Now we have seen that the first part of our paper is title, then abstract, then introduction, methods, result, discussion, / conclusion. But whenever we start writing, we should start with methods, results, discussion, conclusion, then introduction, then abstract, and then title. We have to see that we have to maintain, because the introduction part should contain the result as well as some portion of the analysis. Same thing is true with the abstract. We have to include certain portion of our result. And title should be refined in the last stage. We were discussing about research question and hypothesis, and it would be better if we define the hypothesis. Hypothesis is an educated guess, while a research question is simply a research wondering about the world. Hypotheses are the parts of the scientific research method. It is defined as a guess. If I take an example of a research question, we can ask ourselves that what should be the student support service in IGNOU after 5 years, or what should be the student support service in coming 5 years. This is my research question. Now, hypothesis may be that if we go for online, so we can frame a hypothesis that online teaching will give a support to face-to-face counseling at a study center. Now, this is my hypothesis and the research question. I think that I have clearly differentiated between research question and the hypothesis. Now, before writing, there are certain things which should be considered by you, just like you have to write your research question. Then, on the basis of research question, you have to frame the hypothesis. For example, we have to ask the question that whatever study which we are going to make, what this is for, or what would be the findings from our study. I have given one example that this study sought to find out how many mathematics students are satisfied with their professor in the classroom. Now, there should be some argument of the questions, because it is not easy to gauge the performance of satisfaction or the satisfaction level on the basis of performance. We have to define the performance. So the first part, how many students report satisfaction with the class notes, which is prescribed or which is given by the professor? Or second, what are the most common complaints the student make about their professor? Another important thing before writing, we have to decide that which type of journal we are writing for. We have to read the research articles in our field. We have to read the guideline for the target journal. Now we will come to start a methodology or the chronological order of writing a method. First one is prepare the figures and tables. When I was writing the paper, initially I thought that why I should prepare, why I should create, but when you write a paper, the figures and the data will speak about your paper. That is why it is important to create and gather all the data. You have to number and give the caption and place them in order you want to show them in your result or your in paper. Now, whenever you write a method, first thing is that you have to describe how your experiment were done. Explain why this experimental procedure is chosen, then what is the method of analysis, how the results were obtained. For example, if we are gauging the satisfaction level of students for IGNOU, we will say that a questionnaire was framed with the help of literature review and the faculty members and the counsellors at the study center. Now, why we have chosen this? Because we want to go one to one student and we have to find out and we their response on the questionnaire. Method of analysis. We will use the descriptive method or we will use the statistics. We will use that, suppose we have used the Likert scale 1 to 5. 1 stand for least satisfied and 5 most satisfied. So if the student says most satisfied, then we will award him number 5. It is quite possible that he may write 3, that means moderately satisfied. Now, these are the results which we are getting and we can enter in the SPSS statistical package for social science, that is the software which we normally use. Minitab is another, or R, which is prescribed in the UGC website, that any type of software can be used for entering the data. Now, in organization of information for the method, that we have to collect the information, we have to think that how the materials are prepared, how the measurements are taken, then as I told you that the description of statistics, whatever we are doing, we are taking mean or standard deviation, we are using the regression analysis, we are using the correlation, or we are testing t-test or independent t-test for testing our hypothesis. Now, remember, the method section is only 10% of paper, but it is very important for your research paper. These are the some of the guidelines that we have to use. We should use passive voice and we have to use past tense. But this is not a hard and fast rule. I only suggest that if you are using active voice, you should be consistent throughout the paper. If you are using past tense, you should be consistent throughout the paper. Another important thing, that result should not be discussed in the method, and we have to use certain qualitative and quantitative details about our methods, just like the types of expert which we have selected for preparing the question paper. Then quantitative data, that suppose we have given our questionnaire to 500 students, and out of which how much have been returned, how much are unfilled or are rejected. So all these details we have to write in the method section. Now we are coming to two small quiz, that which statement is not true about the method. Headings are sometimes used in the method section. It is true, because if the method is long and contains different sections or subsections, we have to give separate heading under the method section. Then methods are organized chronologically by the order of importance. This is also true, because the method should be organized how we have conducted the research. Third is the method section that describes that how we have conducted the experiment. Third is method contain the information about the research findings, which is not true, because the research finding will come under the result section. Second question which I ask, that which is the best example of a sentence which will you will find in the method. I am reading from the top. Researchers should search the books using software. Now this is a general statement, which is an advice which we are giving to the researcher. Third one is books on geography are least read in the library. Now it is a type of a conclusion which we are making. Weighing machine results 58.99 and 58.59 kilograms respectively. This is also comes under the result. But if you just give your attention to the first point, that is 154 books of science were placed in the wooden rake or wooden rack. That gives a type of working which has been explained by you in the method section. So this is the best example among the four activities which we have given here. Now under the result section, we will give the present finding, and our finding will be in the same order as we have given in the method. Here we have to present our data which we have obtained in the method in the form of figures, tables or text. We have to also report the about the data collection and the participant, and our research question relevancy with respect to the report data. That is very important, that our research question should match or should map with the reported data. Now how we will organize our result? The first and most important thing is that the order of the result should be the same as the order of method. Second thing is that we should try to answer the research question present in the figures. That means if we are asking a question, which type of business will be profitable in along the IGNOU road, then our data should give reply that yes, the food and beverage or library or gym should be a profitable business along the or in the IGNOU road. So that should come under the result. Now I have taken a very simple example for the result organization. How do visitor over age 60 feel about their visit to shopping mall? This is a research question. Now our result should explain or should provide the data related to this research question. Now, in the result, we, on the basis of method, we are writing the visitor over age of 60 were 40% more likely to report negative with rare visit to the shopping mall. That is the finding of the result. Now, in case of more elaboration, we can give a elaborated result finding that non-availability of sitting area, non-liking of showroom, or prolonged waiting period for the personal issues may be the negative issues which is intending the visitor over 60 years to report negative about their visit to the shopping mall. Now, another question which I am giving to you, that which section or which comment should be included in the result. I am first reading the first one, that background information about your study. It is not coming in the result section because it will come under the introduction section. I am now reading the third one, a concise hypothesis or the problem statement, that also comes under the introduction section. Fourth, data from the related research source, that is coming under the method. Now, if you read the second or the B, the statement about the data in terms of figures and table, that should come under the section result. Now, we will come to the discussion or the conclusion. Now, discussion and conclusion is a section where you can sell your data. You can interpret your data. You can justify your findings. And you have to ask a question. Did your study contribute to the knowledge in the field or not? Now, whole things will depend how you write your discussion or conclusion. Now, before writing a conclusion, you should always see that what is the present state of knowledge and what is the extension you are making from your work. Then, what suggestions you are making for future work, what limitations you are prescribing with respect to your research work, and also how you are claiming your research with reference to the research question. Now we will say that, as we have told, that the introduction part should be written after the conclusion, because here we are trying to include many things about the result and discussion and conclusion in the introduction. So, in the introduction, the first question we should ask, that why our study is important. Then we have to establish the context of the research. We have to find out the gaps in the knowledge and how we are filling up the gap, that we have to mention. We have to mention what is the purpose of research, what is the research question, what is the rationale of our approach, and important findings of the result and the discussion. These are the some of the questions which you have to answer before writing introduction. What is the problem to be solved? What we know about the problem? Is there any existing solution? Or what are the gaps in the knowledge in the existing solution? That on the basis of literature review, what are the limitations or the gaps which are exist or which exist in the literature? Or with the help of a statement of the purpose, how you are achieving this thing. Now we will come to the abstract. That abstract should be accurate, and the 3P should always be remembered: purpose, procedure, and the principal finding. One, you should remember that abstract should be accurate, it should be self-contained, and it should be readable. Means from the abstract, your research paper should be reflected. Title should be short and should be meaningful. It should give you the correct picture of your research which you are reporting in the research paper. Now, with the help of the research paper, we try to give two answers to the two questions, that what is the gap in the knowledge, that is importance of the study, and then how this study will fill that gap, that is the role of study. Another term which is coming nowadays in every journal guidelines, that is a systematic literature review. I will not go in detail because it is almost a very, very lengthy process. But I will say that it is very simple. First, you have to identify your research question. On the basis of research question, you have to identify the keywords. And with the help of keyword, you have to find out the literature in the web database. Now you have collected, suppose, 200 research papers. Now you have to shortlist, or you have to make your sorting short by searching the research paper on the basis of peer review journals or on the basis of language. So we should come to the a short list of the literature. And by reviewing that literature, we will give a systematic literature review. So this is the whole about how you will write a effective research paper. If you have any feedback, you can give me an email at ashish@ignou.ac.in, or you can visit the Facebook of IGNOU online, where you can find this video and you can give your comments and suggestions on my lecture. Thank you.